session 11. In session 11, we are still continuing with our postnatal care. So this session will focus on the further management of the mother during the postnatal period. It incorporates both the physical and emotional well-being of the new mother. And then we have said that we are going to do focus postnatal, where we look at the individuality of the client. By the end of the session, I expect that students will be able to care for the postnatal mother based on their individual needs, note any deviation from the normal based on assessment, and provide appropriate care or referral when needed. We're going to look at immunization of the baby. We're going to talk about the drugs or medications. We're talking about postnatal exercises, deep breathing exercise, family planning, menstruation and coitus, and then postnatal examinations. This is our reading list. Immunization of the baby. The first immunization of the baby is given at birth, and the next dose are 6 weeks postnatal, and subsequent ones are given to protect the baby. Now remember that different countries have different type of immunization schedules for babies. And because we'll be doing immunization extensively in public health, we will not spend too much time going through them, and also in pediatrics, we will not spend too much time going through the immunization schedule in Ghana. And I want to look at drugs or medications. The postnatal mother, they are normally given drugs such as hematinics to raise their hemoglobin level and to replenish the blood loss during labor. Analgesics may also be given for pain relief. And then sometimes we give broad-spectrum antibiotics as prophylaxis against any infection, especially when we give an episiotomy and then we want to prevent infection to the site. Postnatal exercises. It helps to give the mother a sense of well-being. It also encourages good circulation. It lessens the possibility of venous thrombosis formation. And then the woman's muscle tone and abdominal wall and pelvic floor will also be strengthened. Family planning. The mother is educated on the importance of family planning, its benefits, the various methods available, and is assisted to make an informed choice. As much as possible, the father of the baby is included in the education to facilitate its implementation and adherence. Menstruation and resumption of coitus. It is explained to the mother that menstruation commences at the end of the puerperium or within the next month or two. Menstruation can be delayed when the woman is breastfeeding exclusively, like we said, owing to high prolactin levels. I think I've explained this earlier on. And the puerperal mother can resume coitus after 6 weeks or after the cessation of discharges if there are no problems and she had a spontaneous vaginal delivery. We want to look at postnatal examination. The main postnatal examination, after the initial screenings that we have done earlier on by the midwife, there is a need to have a postnatal examination by a general practitioner or the obstetrician at 6 weeks after delivery. And the examination will include assessment of the woman's general physical and mental health and a medical examination. The puerperal woman sees the midwife for postnatal review to identify any abnormalities and monitor the progress of the puerperium. She is also given appointment to the appropriate specialist where necessary. In summary, we have said that the postnatal period is the time when the mother is assessed to determine her adaptation to a role. The baby and mother are examined periodically, the major one at 6 weeks. The examination should be done by obstetrician, and then they should progress to the postpartum phase, and then any deviations or abnormalities should be screened and identified early and referred appropriately. These are the references.